Everybody, this is Professor Dan G from the University of Colorado Boulder, and we have our next. We have homework three, and so yeah, let's. Without further ado, let's get started on this one. This one might be a little quicker, might not. Let's see what we got. So, homework three. Oops, let's share that. So, we're gonna again skip right through to the Gilat, and we're gonna see we have to do chapter three, number 2 and 13. And then we're going to have to use a MATLAB script to solve for the angle alpha. Okay. Here we go. So, chapter three. So, we have our script here. What do we start with? CLC, close all, clear all, and format short G. All right. So, let's see. We have chapter three, number two. So chapter three, number two, it says, for the function, calculate the value of y using element by element operations. So first thing we want to do is if we're using y and we say y equals x to the fourth times the exponent of minus x, we always want to make sure we have x defined first. So we have x, and it says, I'm just going to use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You always want to make sure you're defining your x before your y. So chapter 3, 2. So if we hit go, well, doesn't like it. And remember, it's because we're trying to multiply. X is an array or a matrix. And if we're just trying to multiply the first, so 1 times 1 and 2 times 2 and 3 times 3, or in this case, 1 to the 4th, 2 to the 4th, 3 to the 4th, we need to put our little dot in. I wonder if I can do that. Well, turns out we have to do the same thing with our multiplication. There we go. Once we do that, we're okay, but yeah, make sure you're having your x terms the appropriate one. So now we have to do 13. So 13, it says same thing. It says define a vector. And it says, yeah, v is equal to something. So I'm just going to do something else. 1, 2, 4, 8. Yeah, just make it different. And then if we look, the key to this one is figuring out what's different. So if V is 1, 3, 5, 7, right, I guess we should just do that. That's easy. By now, you should be able to do that pretty easily. So 1, 3, 5, 7, A is it squared, you know, or A is 1, 3, 5, 7 times 3. So A is 3 times V. We do that. Hey, how about that? That worked out. Now, B is the term squared. And remember, if we do V squared, we're going to have an issue. So remember what we just learned in this first part, element by element, use your dot. And so the rest are pretty straightforward. Now, finally, we want to use a MATLAB script to solve for the angle alpha in RNK problem 30A. RNK, so chapter 4, problem 30A is a, it says determine the angle alpha. And it shows a 200-pound box hanging down from a 5-foot cable and a 10-foot cable. And what we know is that the height is the same. And so we only have to find alpha. We don't have to solve the whole problem. So alpha is our question mark. So what do we want to do? Well, we know height is equal to, is it the sine or cosine of 45 times love. And remember to always use the D if you are using degrees. And then we just need to do the same. We need to know if the height is the sine or the cosine of alpha times 10. So that's basically it. You have to figure out if it's the sine or the cosine. And then we would want to use the command a sine d or a cosine d to get the inverse cosine to solve for the alpha. So that's it. Don't make the problem harder than it is. You'd only have to figure out alpha. And that's basically it for our R and K. We got a test coming up, so want to make sure that you have enough time to start studying. So not too much Gilat this week. Good luck, and we'll talk to you later.